Otis and being in the background, always pushing Otis into the spotlight, always taking care of Otis, making sure he was looked after on the road everywhere they went in WWE. And now Tucker has abandoned Otis, and he's got to branch out on his own in singles competition.
There is some truth to what Tucker has said. I mean, if you followed Heavy Machinery and the trajectory of that tag team, you know oftentimes Otis did get the spotlight. But again, the means of doing so, stabbing your best friend in the back at Hell in a Cell, just inexcusable.
Oh, and Humberto Carrillo with a headbutt off the ropes. Tucker is still on his feet, however. Oh, Humberto Carrillo sends the 300-plus pounder.
Look, if you're Tucker, you've placed extra pressure on yourself to stand out now that you are on your own as a singles competitor.
See the anger in the eyes of Tucker as he comes into this matchup. It's very much speed versus power here between Carrillo and Tucker.
Yeah, completely contrasting styles. And listen, when Tucker got drafted to Monday Night Raw,
cross body, Carrillo into the cover and a kick out.
I was excited about his future. I was excited to see what this new chapter would entail. But again, I'd never in a million years expected Tucker to stab his best friend in the back.
First time ever one-on-one matchup between Carrillo and Tucker. Same could be said later on tonight. It's Ricochet versus Angel Garza. First time ever one-on-one. Now the cover by Tucker and a kick out.
And believe me, this match isn't just about beating Humberto Carrillo for Tucker. It's about sending a message.
Another cover. Pounces on top of Carrillo and a kick out.
It's about sending a message to the entire roster of Monday Night Raw about what kind of threat Tucker can be.
Plenty of questions in the fallout from the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view, of course, surrounding Tucker. But how about what transpired in the WWE Championship Hell in a Cell match, a new WWE champion in Randy Orton? What was next for the Viper? How about the former champion Drew McIntyre, as well as the aforementioned new Mr. Money in the Bank, The Miz? We'll take you back to this past week on Raw and show you everything that went down.
So many countless landscape-changing moments coming out of Hell in a Cell.
And a headbutt. Now it's Tucker measuring Carrillo and shades of the WWE Hall of Famer JYD, the Junkyard Dog.
I'm seeing a new viciousness come out of Tucker right now, which should suit him well.
Oh! Kick right to the ribs. Byron, you and I both remember when Otis and Tucker got to be close. When they first bonded, they were competing in armories throughout the state of Florida. Otis was brand new to the WWE Performance Center. Some would argue that Tucker needed Otis to get to WWE heights that he did.
I agree with you. I mean, and Tucker did his part to help guide Otis and break him in a little bit into our industry, but Tucker.
Well, Tucker into the cover, hook to the leg, and a kick out.
Tucker thrived off the energy that Otis brought to the equation.
Oh, now look at this, the body scissors. And remember, Tucker has a great amateur wrestling background. Watch this.
Now just completely controlling Humberto Carrillo.
Was an All-American at Arizona State University in his career.